So let me just show you some of the results that you can get using that. All right. So here are, again, this is taken from the Berkeley database, and because she and Malik, Jean Bashi and Senator Malik did normalized cuts. And you can see that there are some pretty good results here. You know, you like, especially like this one here, where it breaks up the picture of the people in a particular way. Now, of course, these segmentation is tremendously influenced by that affinity matrix, and the affinity matrix is defined by that distance function. So we're back to feature spaces again, right? We have to know what features we should be computing a space over. We may have to scale the features because all of that determines the distances. But once you do that and you play with that, you can end up with a really powerful segmentation method. By the way, you'll notice that there are more than two segments in these pictures. Well, so how do you do that? Well, the simplest is you partition your graph, and then what do? You partition again, partition again, and you need a stopping criteria based upon sort of the affinities of the links that you're cutting. Here are some more examples also taken from the Berkeley database for segmentation.